Let's go.
We meet again.
Thank you for saving me. People say all kinds of things about witches, but I've always known yours to be an honorable guild.
So you managed to salvage some goods?
Yes, but I await the repair of my wagon. As time passes, my losses grow. Do you need something? I'll let it go half free.
Let me have a look at your stock. Slow now. Whoa. Hey-ya! Whoa there, Roach. A stream, amber waves of grain. Charming place. Perfect for an ambush.
I know how to choose them. So, ready?
Let's start. Wind's good. Bait's scent will spread quickly.
Now all we have to do is wait. Come on, we can cower in the shade of those birches.
So tell me, once we find Yennefer, what'll you do? Got your eye on a contract?
No, I'll go to Kaer Morhen.
Little early to settle in for the winter.
Snows are a way off, yes. And that's what worries me. Nilfgaard's crossed the Pontar in the east. Puts them maybe a week's march from Kaer Morhen. If they reach the valley before snows can cover the passes, well, we need to cover our tracks, hide our paths. Speaking of winter and wintering, think you'll come this year?
Maybe. Might bring a guest. Witcher with a crossbow? We breaking with tradition?
Stop talking. Got a griffin to kill.
Fast!
not bad. Though you could stand to improve some things.
Man spends his whole life learning.
Not a Witcher, unless he doesn't want to live long. But more on that later. Take the Griffin's head to the Black Ones. I'll ready our horses. Meet me at the inn.
Take it easy.
Whoa!
place of power. Come on now.
Heard of the Pie-Head Brigade? It's
your kind, sir.
Non-humans. Sheath the sword now.
Yeah, besides your weapon.
That stench.
We have much work to do here. Quite a lot.
What a load of pest! I will
be a beast!
Stop!
What the hell is this?
Roy!
You take me for a blind man or a fool? This grain is rotten.
I didn't know.
So, a fool. Damn it, you never learn. Military Codex, Article 2, Section 3. For the delivery of defective goods, 15 lashes with a knout. Make it so.
No, no, no! By the gods, no!
What?
Fulfilled my end of the bargain. Your turn. Where'd Yennefer go?
To Vizima.
She was a day's ride from here the whole time? Under my nose? Might have said so.
Yes, I might have. But you would not have killed the griffin. Tit for tat. Halt! We are not done. It's yours, this gold. I would not want you to say you were inadequately compensated.
Non-humans.
Yes. Wish to enlist, Nordling?
Loar and I think.
Yes.
Talk to the commander. Loar and I say.
Do not get food, not from me.
Run, Roach.
Hey, go out.
Come on.
That's it, Roach.
Come on now. Take it here. Slow now. Whoa. Get here. Come on, Roach. What now, you piece of filth? Whoa there, Roach. Let's go!
Yennefer's in Vizima. Got a few friends there, so... Something wrong?
Look around. Trouble brewing.
Who are they?
Patriots. Drinking their seventh round for Temeria. Fist starting to itch.
Don't see any Nilfgaardians.
They'll find another foe.
I'll buy some provisions for the journey. Then we'll go.
Geralt. We should stay out of it. Just this once.
What happened to the lilies?
Took them down.
Took them down? To hang a golden sun there now?
I cannot show Temerian colours. They'll come and burn the tavern down.
Maybe it's true what they say. You fund of the Imperials, you Nilfgaard's whore.
I'll let that pass. I know grief eats at your heart.
You know shit. They hang my sister, dragged her out the cloister like a dog. Said Nilfgaard's no place for superstition, that they don't fear the wrath of the gods. And you, do you fear it? If not for Annie, your child would have choked on its navel string. You owe your son to my sister attending to the birth, and you don't fear the god's wrath. You don't fear it, you cunt! Leave me be!
Recognize this medallion? You know what it means. Back off.
You all right?
They say witches steal young'uns. That's true. What'd the Emperor promise you, freaks? Your own land, like he did the elves once?
Get out, all of you.
We ain't going nowhere. And neither are you.
They won't back down now.
I can see that.
We're finished!
It's all right. It's over.
Leave me be! Get away!
See his face! God save us!
Be gone. And don't ever come back.
So much for not getting involved. Come on, let's go.
That brawl, we didn't start it.
Excuses, excuses. You've not changed a bit.
Yen? How?
I received a report about a witcher who'd appeared in White Orchard. I knew it was you, looking for me. I might have waited until you found me, but... well, you know me. Patience has never been my strong suit. It's... good to see you, Geralt. I'd even embrace you. Were you not covered in blood?
Sorry. I wasn't expecting to see you. To be honest, this isn't at all how I imagined we'd meet.
How did you imagine it?
You didn't imagine you'd have a Nilfgaardian escort. Don't get me wrong, Yennefer. I'm glad to see you. But I do think you owe us an explanation.
And I shall provide it. In Vizima. Ready your horses.
Spent the last 6 months in the saddle. Haven't seen you for 2 years. Can't we take a moment to...
Sadly, we cannot. Someone awaits you, Geralt. Someone who doesn't like to be kept waiting. Emperor Emir Var Emrys. Or, to those on more intimate terms with him, the white flame dancing on the graves of his foes.
Doubt I number among that group. For as I remember, last time we saw each other, he wanted to kill me.
Well... now he wishes to make you an offer.
The kind one can't refuse?
I didn't, though I could have.
Must have been a damn good offer then. Not many things you'd give up your freedom for, and even fewer people.
The sooner we set off, the sooner you'll find out.
What about you?
I'm going in the opposite direction. I somehow doubt the Emperor's invitation mentioned me. Besides, I've got things to do at Caermore, remember?
Yeah, I remember. Thanks for your help, Vesemir. See you soon.
How's your horse? Swift?
Can't complain. Why do you ask?
I'd like to be back behind some thick city walls as soon as possible.
Thank you.
This bard's tale begins near White Orchard, with my dear friend Geralt of Rivia seeking his lover of yore, the sorceress Yennefer. She'd eluded him for years, but now seemed just a few steps ahead. After many trials and tribulations, Geralt finally learned that Yen was in nearby Vizima.
It must suffice.
Think of your cares if I'm clean.
The gentleman will refer to His Imperial Majesty by his full title or not at all. The gentleman will be seated on the bergère.
The what now?
In that chair. Tetwin, please shave the gentleman's sideburns to half an inch.
What's wrong with my beard? Always thought it added to my dignity.
It does. Yet it also detracts from your elegance. In Nilfgaard, we consider beards hard on the eyes. Especially beards infested with lice.
Been on the road a while. Fine. Do your thing.
Tilt your head back, please, and sit still.
And prepare to answer some questions.
General, I am not certain this is the appropriate time.
I can't think of a better time. Men turn honest when they feel a blade at their throat. Morvran Voris, commander of the Alba Division. Before they take you in to see the Emperor, Witcher, there's some information I need you to verify. It's a formality. But one that must be seen to.
Sure. Paperwork's gotta be in order.
So, Geralt of Rivia. Place of birth unknown. Parents unknown. Age unknown. All insignificant details. Let us proceed to more recent events. The siege of La Valette Castle. The fate of the defending commander, one Arion.
Test ordered me to clear the path. The boy stood in my way.
Cutting down the La Valette air. This made no impression on you? I suppose it wouldn't. What's some baron to an assassin of kings? Moving on. You then found shelter in charming Flotsam, and from there made your way to Vergen. My question is how?
I got out of Flotsam with Vernon Roach, commander of the Blue Stripes, and...
A murderer of non-humans. We know this gentleman well, Witcher. You forge interesting alliances.
Something tells me my most interesting is yet to come. Go on, next question, before my beard grows back in.
We shall shave you again if it does. Very well. The infamous summit at Lochmuin. You were there, and once again meddled in the affairs of the mighty.
The mighty had imprisoned Triss Marigold. Ought to know I care about her, and I tend to rescue those I care about.
And so you did, handing Radovid control of the Conclave and Council of Mages in the process.
Nilfgaard recently started a war, unprovoked. So do us both a favor and stop moralizing.
The gentleman must sit still.
I'm almost done.
I'm afraid I might find that difficult. Because, from what I know, shortly afterwards you watched a defective megascope blow your friend Sheila de Tansaville to bits.
An old acquaintance, more like. Not so close that I felt bad for her, but close enough that I knew she deserved it.
He believes he alone knows what is good and what is evil, and that this gives him the right to dispense justice. Your comrade Letho of Gullet described you so. Quite accurate, I'd say.
My comrade, your agent.
Well, national interest calls on one to forge difficult alliances at times. Alliances with witches.
What's Letho up to?
I had hoped you would answer that question.
Ah, so Letho's hiding from you. Must have a good reason. Was there a shift in national interest that might have caused that? I don't know where he is. Wouldn't tell you if I did anyway. Blade or no blade to my throat.
I believe that is all. Your signature, please, affirming you stated the whole truth and nothing but the truth on pain of imprisonment or death, etc., etc. Here and here.
With these formalities seen to, I would ask the general to leave the room. We shall be choosing the gentleman's attire. An important matter, but one that does not require the general's assistance.
Shame. I might have given you some advice. So long, Geralt. Good luck with your audience.
Feels more like I'm being readied for a wedding.
Were that so, I would have prepared the gentleman a frock, a tailcoat, or possibly a dinner jacket. In point of fact, the gentleman will choose from these garments.
Black, black, or black?
We do not like garish colors in Nilfgaard. The gentleman will tell me once he has chosen an outfit.